Viewers, you heard first of Shehla Rashid in 2016 when she allegedly took part in a massive anti-India protest in the Jawaharlal Nehru University. Those are the pictures from back then. At the time, the opposition criticized those who wanted her, along with other students, to be booked for sedition. Remember, there was a clamor. Many people said that for saying Bharat Tere Tukde Tukde and chanting several other anti-India slogans, Shehla Rashid and some of her friends, co-students, should be charged with sedition. The opposition then said that a student's free speech can't be muzzled, especially in a center of learning, a cradle of education. Now, thanks to the support from the Congress and opposition, Shehla Rashid has graduated to committing allegedly far greater crimes. If the army is to be believed today, Shehla Rashid is guilty of inciting a dangerous riot in Kashmir at a sensitive time like this, when the state is preparing for what many people believe is going to be a massive backlash or reaction to the abrogation of Article 370. That's right, Shehla Rashid stunned one and all by claiming that the Indian army was torturing young boys, ransacking houses, deliberately spilling rations on the floor, mixing oil with rice, etc. They enter their houses at night, she said. Her tweets caused restiveness in the valley. She said that in Shopian, four men were called into the army camp and interrogated. In brackets, she writes, tortured. A mic was kept close to them so that the entire area could hear them scream and be terrorized. This created an environment of fear in the entire area. This is what Shehla Rashid was busy tweeting. These were both tweets that were a series of 10 tweets that were put out. However, the Indian Army hit back and exposed her tweets as a big lie, full of fake facts. A statement attributed to the Indian Army suggests the following: allegations leveled by Shehla Rashid are baseless and rejected. Such unverified and fake news are spread by inimical elements, some organizations trying to incite unsuspecting population. Viewers, her tweets have led to a massive, massive debate. Many people are today asking, who's going to take responsibility for such tweets that could lead to a massive, massive riot security situation in the valley? Should this individual be booked under the appropriate laws contained in the penal code for sedition, for anti-India activities? That's what a complainant has sought to demand from the highest court in the land. But there are many in the opposition, even now, viewers, and I'm going to play out some of their sound bites, who have come out and supported Shehla Rashid, praising her, in fact, praising her for, viewers, taking up cudgels on behalf of those who don't have a voice, for suggesting that she has the courage to speak up against the NDA, and for highlighting serious allegations against the army. Yes, there are elements within the opposition, within the Congress party, within the NCP, that say that the army should not be trusted, and that they hope that these allegations are not true. And all of this, of course, at a time when the army is trying to hold down what many people believe is a massive conspiracy from across the border to incite violence in the valley. Listen to some of these sound bites.
देखिए हमारा हमारी कामना है कि आर्मी जो कुछ कह रही है और जो कुछ कश्मीर के विषय में दिखाया जा रहा है वही स्थिति हमारी सोच यह है कि सरकार ने 370 के विषय में कश्मीर के आवाम को वहाँ के इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स को विश्वास में लेना चाहिए था उनसे बातचीत करने के बाद ही कोई कदम उठाया जाना चाहिए था शांति चाहते हैं हम और जैसा जैसा दिखाया जा रहा है भगवान करे वही स्थिति हो, मगर हम सब कश्मीर को लेकर के आशंकाओं से घिरे हुए हैं।
शीला रशीद इज अमंग दोज एक्टिविस्ट हु आर गैदरिंग करेज टू स्पीक अगेंस्ट द सेंटर्स एक्ट फॉलोइंग द 370 एब्रोगेशन, बिकॉज यू सी हॉलिंग अप लीडर्स एंड इवन स्मॉलर लीडर्स नाउ, एंड द रिपोर्ट सजेस्ट दैट सम इवन माइनर्स आर detained. So there is an hue and cry with regard to violation of human rights, and whether there is in fact human right violation or not is a matter which is in fact sub judice before Supreme Court. So we can't say either way. Indian Army is not above law. Indian Army also has certain discipline to be followed. So if they breach it, they have to fear. If they have not breached it, they don't have to bother about it at all.
Well, there's some basic questions. If Shehla Rashid is so sure of her facts, why hasn't she listed them in those tweets? And how is it that such serious charges are almost an afterthought? Tweet 9 and tweet 10. I mean, this is what she's saying. And this has the potential of inciting young minds in Kashmir to go out there and carry out acts of violence against the Indian state. These are very serious allegations. Does it not devolve upon Shehla Rashid to adduce proof to back her charges? And I want to go straight across, in fact, to Dr. Fahad Haleem of the left parties, Arjun Shiran and advocate Sabha Naqvi. Sabha Naqvi, I want to ask you, Shehla Rashid was a student in 2016 in JNU. At that time, she launched a massive campaign against the Indian security forces. Fine, she was in a university. Many people said we must give her benefit of doubt, because students are meant to actually challenge the narrative, ask questions. But she's no longer a student. She's a member now of a political party. She's in Kashmir and she's making allegations which the army has found very easy to rebut. Should she be making these allegations?
So can I first of all, I mean, just clarify for me that who is you're saying these tweets are going to create an uproar. I have not been able to contact mobile phones in Kashmir, so I don't know. It's only journalists who seem to have those, most from Delhi, who seem to have access to Twitter. The local Kashmiris are not accessing Twitter. So who is going to see her tweets? Number one. Rahul, number two, she may not be a student. She's a citizen of India. She's a Kashmiri. She has every right. No, you can't comment till I finish. She has every right to offer points of views as are pointed. Now the army is not above the law. And if Shehla is serious about the issues that she's flagged, then she should give some more details. And for you to suggest, Rahul, that somehow one girl's tweet is going to be responsible for alienating an entire valley where the entire political leader, traditional political leadership is incarcerated, where we haven't heard from anyone for a long time, where I cannot contact, where the editor of Kashmir Times came to Delhi and said she cannot get in touch with her own reporter. She held a press conference the other day. I have been trying desperately, having covered Kashmir, to try and get through to people because I have mobile numbers. I cannot get through to people. So let's not paint this picture that one girl is somehow going to incite people who were not consulted, their voices were not this, and this was done. So Sabha tell Naqvi, me of the valley, the people of the valley, how many have been asked?
Sabha
They've
Naqvi,
locked up everyone.
Sabha
and
Naqvi.
I have no thing in saying it.
Sabha Naqvi, today,
in a very undemocratic way.
Today,
please
today,
carry on. Please carry on.
Sabha Naqvi, first of all, these aren't a point of view as you have suggested. These are accusations against the army. When you say, and let me quote this lady, when you say, in Shopian, four men were called into the army camp and tortured, a mic was kept near them so that the entire area could be terrorized. This army torture created an environment of fear in the area. This is not a point of view. Surely you know that. This is an accusation against the army.
That's
Second,
I believe Shehla,
armed forces are entering Shehla houses at night.
The details and the army and.
No, no, 1 second. Armed forces are entering houses at night, picking up
Why
boys.
Why is this surprise? I mean, do you really think in Shopian? Hang on, hang on.
Army ransacking, deliberately spilling rations on the floor, etc.
You have not. Okay, anyway.
These are accusations. I mean, would you dispute the fact that these are accusations?
I've almost got shot at once.
Ma'am, I'm only asking you a simple question. I'm asking you a simple question. You said this was a point of view, and everyone is entitled to a point of view. Do you consider these tweets a point of view, or do you consider them an accusation?
No,
first, let's settle this.
They are accusations, and we should get facts verified. And you should not be so shocked that army enters at night. There is a mop-up operation going on in South Kashmir.
Excuse me, ma'am.
We all know
you,
that.
You might be sitting here and
you
saying
know,
all these things.
No,
hang on, hang on. Listen, listen. Show me the proof. Let's have the proof. No, if these are accusations,
we
then in every every person
zone in the world.
With an elementary passing knowledge of the law will tell you that you can't make an accusation without
why
a modicum
is it so
of.
Necessary?
No, no. 1 minute. Are we in the realm of rumor? Sabha Naqvi, let me ask one of the most notable lawyers in this country, Aryama Sundaram. Aryama Sundaram, do you believe, first of all, that these are inflammatory? Second, if there are accusations, do you believe that this individual, at a time such as this, a very sensitive time, when forget about, you know, hyperactivists, you have countries, you have elements inimical to India who are trying to create a narrative internationally. Do you think at a time like this, an individual like Shehla Rashid should be making accusations without adducing any proof? Simple question to you.
Well, a very simple answer, Rahul. I'm probably one of the greatest advocates of freedom of speech. I feel freedom of speech is basic, absolutely basic to a democracy, and is a must, is a necessity. But I also believe that there are innate and intrinsic restrictions on the exercise of that right. Amongst them, let's look at the Article 19.2 itself. It restricts it when it's going to incite violence. It's restricted when it's going to affect a public order. It's restricted when it's defamatory. These are all restrictions on the freedom of speech. Now, in a situation like this, while everybody has the right to criticize the decision on 370, to support it, everybody has a right, because that is your freedom. But when you exercise that right, given the subject matter, given the kind of provocative statements which could be made, it becomes all the more reason and all the more important that you are very careful about what you say, that you know the veracity of what you're saying. What you're saying is backed by truth. Now, let's make one more thing very clear. If you were to say something in criticizing Article 370, the decision on Article 370, well, that itself is all right. But if you're going to make an out-and-out accusation, unless you can back that accusation by proof, without a doubt, you are guilty of completely misusing your freedom of speech, and you're also guilty of various other criminal offenses, including the offense of inciting violence, including the offense of being defamatory, including various other offenses. And especially when you do it in a sensitive subject like this, surely your right to speak can be restricted than saying, sorry, what you're doing is attacking the very sovereignty integrity of India on the ground that what you're saying is false. However, if what she's saying is true, that is a totally different matter. But I do not find right now that she has made any effort to come out to back what she's saying with any facts. But of course, if she can show it's true, then her right to speak is fine. But of course, tempered with that caveat that you, while you speak, even if you're speaking the truth, what you should say should not be such as to incite or be provocative or otherwise.
There you go.
Create a situation of public order.
Hang on.
That
can
should
I,
not
there
be
is,
done.
There are innate restrictions.
Can I counter that?
No, 1 second. 1 second. Yes, you can counter that.
Counter that,
ma'am.
Can
first
I
of all, it's
that?
Defamatory.
I take strong
first
objection.
Of all, it is against public order. Thirdly, there is no proof adduced. These are accusations being made in a very sensitive environment. Who's going to take responsibility if tomorrow 30 or 40 of our security
Forget
forces
Shehla.
Are corralled,
yeah.
attacked, murdered? Will you? Will you take responsibility?
Okay, so now, I want to respond to the idea, Hang on, I'm not taking any response because if I made charges like this, I would back it up. There's no doubt about that. However, I completely disagree with the idea that Mr. Aryaman Sundaram, for whom I have the greatest respect, all of you propagate that there is a, that you can, supposing I go as a journalist and I find shocking things happening on the ground, are you saying it's so sensitive? We are taking away our freedoms to report with this kind of attitude.
Ma'am, when you report, you report factually. You don't.
Not at all, madam. Not at all. Not at all. Factual reporting is permitted. If it is factual, of course it's permitted. I'm sorry, madam. I think you misunderstood what I said.
A news report is based on quotes.
Your right to report,
it's based on facts.
Your right to speak is not taken away.
To hear that.
No, what do you mean you're glad to hear that? You see, ma'am, this is a problem. Saman Naqvi, there is a massive problem. In 2016, people like you went out there and defended these individuals when they made the most outlandishly, unfortunately, anti-India statements. And this is what has emboldened them. Let me read out something that the High Court judge said.
First of all,
let me read out.
Do we want
because
to
these have proven to be prophetic, these words. Here is the judgment in my hand.
Convicted?
Page 21
has
of
Shehla
23 pages. 1 minute, ma'am, let me bring out the facts before
has
the public.
Ever been convicted?
We are not gossip mongers. Now let me read out.
Has Kanhaiya, have the criminal charges held up?
They haven't held up because the sanction to file those charges have not been given by the Aam Aadmi Party, a government of Kejriwal, which, by the way, you are sympathetic to and that you actually have some sort of dealing with also. So let's not try to today cover up Sawa Naqvi. Now I want to come to point 47, clause 47 in this judgment. This is the WP number 558 of 2016. 1 minute, Sabha Naqvi. 1 minute, page 21 of 23.
So you decide they are guilty.
The thoughts reflected. I am not saying that anyone is guilty.
No.
I am saying, is this person today inciting trouble by rumor mongering?
Is Shehla not a citizen of India?
But she cannot be an irresponsible citizen of India. There is a law. And she has to remain confined within that law. If she doesn't believe that to be a fact, she doesn't think that that law applies to her, she's free to go anywhere she wants to. And in fact, let me tell you what Shehla Rashid has been saying. But before that, I want to read out what the judge says. The thoughts reflected in the slogans raised by some of the students of JNU who organized and participated in that program cannot be claimed to be protected as fundamental right to freedom of speech and expression. I'm not saying this, this is what the judge said. And he goes on to say, I consider this as a kind of infection from which such students are suffering, which needs to be controlled / cured before it becomes an epidemic. Had we perhaps controlled this then, we wouldn't have had the epidemic today.
Shehla Rashid was not one of the accused in that case. Shehla Rashid was not one of the accused in that case.
I am talking about, sir, the culture of trying to protect individuals who were way out of line, and that is what is emboldening them.
These
will those political parties like the left parties? 1 minute, Mr. Shoran, I'll come out to you. I want to first bring in 1 minute, sir. I want to first bring in the left parties.
These individuals represent the country's
youth. Mr. Shoran, 1 minute.
And Mr.
1 minute.
Rahul, you are being a fear monger at this stage.
I'm being a fear monger.
These are innocuous tweets, which are based on her conversations with people.
These are not innocuous tweets,
stated that
Mr. Shoran. Which
inquiry.
Kuku land are you
what
living
I
in?
GVL
Narasimha Rao wants to come
wait,
in on
wait,
this
Rahul.
Point.
What I ask you is this. You have asked
Nobody
Shehla for
the
proof.
Law of the land.
What my,
sir,
I ask you is, have you
sir,
asked the army
maligning the army is not an
the
innocuous act. It is not a harmless act.
No,
it is a very grave offence without proof.
Kunal
now, you can say whatever you want to against the army as long as you have the proof to back up every claim that you make. You know this. You're a lawyer. You've got books right behind you. Look over your shoulder.
Is army above the constitution?
Wait a minute.
I am a lawyer. I am telling you what
yes.
she did was perfectly legal.
She's
Rahul.
Perfectly
she
within her rights to say
legal.
That the
all
army is dragging in. No, no,
right.
the army
right.
drags
like,
boys,
like
ask him
in tortures them, puts a mic near their mouth and goes about
Rahul,
terrorizing the locality.
Here, Rahul, can I come in here?
Yes, another lawyer wants to come in. Go ahead. Go ahead, ma'am.
Thank you, Rahul. Rahul, I want to make two quick points. Firstly, as Mr. Araman Sundaram said, that absolute right to freedom of speech is not available. It comes with reasonable restrictions. If you have rights, you have duties also. Secondly, she should be booked for hate crime under various provisions of Indian Penal Code. Why? Because she is creating hatred on the basis of region, religion, okay, threatening the unity, integrity of India, and trying to invoke crime. The breach of peace. Now, do not take Shehla as one individual.
You are a BJP lawyer, that is why you are making these misstatements. I am sorry you are misstating the law before a national
she's
media.
Part of, can I complete, Rahul, can I complete? Without this running commentary, please.
One second. Just a minute.
Thank you.
Let me step in here. There's some breaking news. I'm going to come back to this debate. There's some breaking news coming in. The Prime Minister has just had a conversation with President of the United States, Donald Trump. And the Prime Minister has allegedly shamed Imran Khan, exposed his bid to destabilize Jammu and Kashmir. Let me just go straight across to Megha Prasad. Megha, this comes on the back of what many people believed was a show of strength by Pakistan in the United Nations Security Council. Both the United States and Russia backed India. The Prime Minister calling President Trump. What has transpired?
Well, Rahul, you know, officially what the Prime Minister's office has shared with us, saying that it was a 30-minute warm conversation between President Trump and Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And remember, Rahul, this also comes right after that embarrassing episode where President Trump had said that that Mr. Modi had in fact asked him to negotiate and be the one who, you know, is helping India and Pakistan finding a middle path for the Kashmir situation.
Yeah.
Right after that, this conversation is important because Prime Minister, as per his office, they are saying that they have discussed various different issues, including the Afghanistan issue.
As far
as Pakistan is concerned, we do not have a clear indication as to whether that cropped up in the conversation between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and President Trump. But a host of issues, and also coming right before the G7 summit, they have discussed issues that perhaps will be on the table in the upcoming summit.
Well, in the context of the regional situation, the Prime Minister stated that extreme rhetoric and incitement to anti-India violence by certain leaders in the region was not conducive to peace. He highlighted to Trump the importance of creating an environment free from terror and violence and eschewing cross-border terrorism without exception. And this is exactly what the Prime Minister has told Donald Trump, the President of the United States, making it very clear that India will not suffer any attempt through extreme rhetoric and incitement, violence against it. Very, very important. That's the tweet in the context of the regional situation. Prime Minister Narendra Modi stated that extreme rhetoric and incitement to anti-India violence by certain leaders in the region was not conducive to peace. This is a direct reference, viewers, to what Imran Khan has been saying over the last few days, trying to create a fear psychosis. Unfortunately, there are many takers on Indian soil for this kind of propaganda. And we are discussing one such individual, and that's Shehla Rashid, who has today shocked the nation, viewers, shocked the nation by using language to accuse the army that, quite frankly, verges on the defamatory, and there has been a complaint filed with the highest court. And I want to bring in G.V.R. Narasimha Rao. G.V.R. Narasimha Rao, many people will say, what's wrong? Shehla Rashid is within her rights to make statements exposing what your government is trying to cover up by muzzling Kashmiris.
Rahul, there is certainly freedom of speech, but there is no freedom to spread fake news deliberately. There is no freedom to indulge in paid propaganda. There is certainly, you can't, the people of this country know that there are several stooges of Pakistan in this country who've been advancing this agenda based on certain consideration. They have no credibility in this country. I think we have been discussing this one such individual since morning who doesn't deserve any attention, but this is their claim to fame. They want to shock nation by making such irresponsible and fraudulent statements, and based on that they want to become a voice of Kashmir. Another Asiya Andrabi. I think this government is certainly putting people like that in their place. And you have a freedom of speech, but you cannot indulge in paid propaganda as a stooge of Pakistan.
Okay.
How is this statement different from anyone making such fraudulent statements from Pakistan? And by making such statements, they are saying we are freely moving around in the valley. I think 3 days ago, some of these activists said that we spent 5 days going around the valley. So in a way, they are saying their situation is normal. If they were prevented from going around, how did they go around for 5 days?
Okay, well,
and
let me tell you.
This female, how did she claim that she is talking to people?
Big breaking news coming in. Big breaking news coming in. Big breaking news coming in. And I'm going to bring you in, Dr. Fahad Halim, right now. Legal trouble for Shehla Rashid. The Delhi police have taken cognizance of a complaint filed against Shehla Rashid for inciting hate as well as violence. I want to bring in Nikunj Garg, Delhi Cyber Cell, scrutinizing the tweets. Nikunj?
Absolutely, Rahul. The complaint has been received by the Commissioner of Police this morning. It has been now given to the cyber cell of the special cell of Delhi Police. Interestingly, this is the same cell, the anti-terror unit of the Delhi Police, which filed its charge sheet in the Tukde gang case also of the JNU. So it's once again back to its job subversive activities against the country, so as to say, and they're examining under what sections the cognizable offences can be made out. As you and I speak, the complaint is in their custody and the legal process has started. Vetting will take place, and it looks at this stage, it looks that an FIR is very, very likely against Ms. Rashid.
Okay, well, there you have it, Dr. Fahad Halim. Do you support the police's action tonight?
Yeah. Rahul, at the onset, let me congratulate you. I didn't hear the entire program because your link was disturbed. But the little that I heard of your opening statements, you made a reporting from the ground of Kashmir concretely. And you said that the government of India is preparing to face a massive backlash. Now, that's at variance with the position of the government of India. And I congratulate you for showing that courage, because that is the dichotomy of
the
dilemma.
Get to the point, sir. Get to the point. I asked you, should this action be taken?
And the rosy picture.
Should this action be taken?
Sir,
simple.
If you want to disturb,
don't give me a.
If you want me
a
to,
word
if,
by word verbatim recount of what I've said, and waste the time of the viewer. Answer the question.
If you want to
should this individual
Rahul,
be prosecuted
Rahul, you can,
for
you can,
sowing you, the seeds of hate against the army, whatever the circumstances
me.
In the valley? It doesn't
continue
matter.
Continue your terrorist activity. Continue your terrorist activity against me. Continue your terrorist activity against me. If you don't let me speak. Become a what you call a news terrorist, I don't mind. And that's the problem that India is facing at this point of time. Because you have concretely said that the government of India is preparing itself for facing
India.
A severe backlash.
People like you
now,
terrorize people.
The question
over
here, Rahul, is that since you have already concluded that the situation in the valley is not normal, that's what the government of India has submitted to the Supreme Court. Let's be very clear. It's the government of India that is telling the constitutional apex institution that the situation in the valley is not normal. Please do not conclude your judgment. Let's be very clear. That's the way the government of India is pleading in the
Rahul,
laws of the court.
Is anyone denying anything? Get on with the point I'm making. That doesn't give anyone the license to spread fake news, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. We are coming to that. I'm saying.
Rahul,
now when the Home Minister spreads fake news in Parliament,
give some time
he
to the
tells
government.
The nation, he tells
they are
Parliament
the report from the
that
ground, from district
we are going to have a very,
slowly,
very normal
steadily,
situation very soon.
Restrictions also.
And on the
give
ground
them
reality,
time.
We see.
I'm asking you, sir, do you support Shehla Rashid
Madam,
when she says that the army is torturing
activity.
Young men, taking them into their camp and putting mics to their mouths while they are being tortured so that their screams and shrieks can terrorize the other people in the valley? I'm simply asking you, do you think that is objectionable
my
or not?
My simple question.
I'm asking you this question.
My simple answer.
I'm asking
my
you.
My simple answer to you, I find it exceptionally objectionable. I find it
well, then get to the point.
Objectionable.
You find it objectionable.
That the government of India is not revealing to the people of India how many people are arrested in Kashmir. What is your answer, Rahul, as a journalist, if you ask
are
the
you
government
saying,
of India, how
are
many
you
people
saying today,
have been arrested in the
are
valley
you saying
as of
today,
the government
that four
of
men
India
were
has,
among
has,
many
has
more called into
like
the army camp
saying,
and
Rahul,
interrogated?
That,
are you saying?
The government of India is... I am saying that the government of India is playing part and parcel its role in the rumor mongering by not revealing the facts on the ground to the people of India.
Okay, so the government of India,
let us see.
You find it a problem. You find it a problem. Okay, let me bring in. Let me bring in. Let me bring in. One second. Let me bring in very quickly G.V. Narasimha Rao.
Kashmir
the left, the left viewers,
48 hours,
the left supported Shehla Rashid, Kanhaiya Kumar, Umar
Imran Khan.
Hello,
Rahul.
Yes. I can't hear you, sir.
My question to GBL is very clear. Imran Khan spoke. Imran Khan spoke to Donald Trump 48 hours ago. What behoves the Prime Minister of India to respond to Donald Trump? Donald Trump.
Okay, one second. One second. Dr. Fahad Halim, you're going completely off the subject. You obviously don't want to answer the question I asked you very pointedly. You sympathize with Shehla Rashid, most probably. And I think we need to get the BJP in on this. The left once again supporting Shehla Rashid and several others of her ilk who have actually gone ahead in the past and also incited individuals in JNU. G.V. Narasimha Rao, you need to respond. They're putting the blame squarely at your door.
No, Rahul. People of this country know how the CPM, the party that he represents, how it has become a China-Pakistan mouthpiece. We have seen on many occasions them not forgetting the national interest and towing Pakistani line. Separatists, when separatists were on the back foot, you had communist leaders going to the residences of separatists. I think you don't need any rivals or enemies if you have your own political parties that are actually militating against national interest in this for the sake of at the altar of their party politics. And I have no hesitation in saying it was
so
communist
GBL,
leaders
you
who
as
spoke
BJP
in the same
BJP
line.
You yourself do not know
CPM state secretary said army,
in
Indian army
what
are rapists.
What can be more unfortunate
Indian
for a nation when you have
this
the ruling party not willing to give
the
facts
the
on the ground? You have the ruling party spokesperson
to
who himself
that
is not aware of what the ground reality in Kashmir is.
I find it astounding that there are individuals on this panel that cannot bring themselves to say today with absolute unambiguity that Shehla Rashid has crossed the line. Now, what holds these individuals back? That's the question that we need to ask. Mr. Shuran, it's certainly not the law. Because Aryama Sundaram, as well as Monica Arora, have laid down the law. So what is it, sir? What misplaced sensibilities and sympathies?
I must clarify.
Do you have?
Monica ji, what she has said is not the correct position, and what Surindram ji said is the correct position, and I think what Shehla said is not objectionable. Whatever she said
so
based on certain conversations.
The police,
and she has
the
also
police
asked the army
is lodging
to conduct
an FIR
and fair
under
inquiry.
Various sections
we
of IPC,
that in the past,
which are
the
hate crime sections.
One minute.
Acts against
you saw the breaking
population,
news?
Against Kashmiris.
Should I tell the sections
terror?
Also?
We know
Section
that for a fact.
Section 292,
okay.
295,
so 298, Mr. Shuran says that Aryama Sundaram agrees with him. Aryama Sundaram, let me bring you back into this debate. Okay, listen to Mr. Aryama Sundaram, Mr. Shuran, since he says, since you say that he agrees with you. 1 minute. Aryama Sundaram, 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute, Monica Arora, 1 second. I want to bring in Aryama Sundaram. Please. Mr. Shuran says Aryama Sundaram agrees with his point of view that Shehla Rashid has done no wrong. Now, Aryama Sundaram, you need to set the record right. You're an advocate for free speech, but beyond the point...
His interpretation of the law is correct. That's all I said.
Sorry, I must clarify. We are talking about, sir, the comment
Rahul,
we are not talking about the interpretation of the law. We are talking about the comment, the rights and the wrongs of the comment. So, Mr. Sundaram, make your point.
As I see it,
Rahul,
is completely
I don't
fine.
Think,
I don't care what the world thinks about
yes,
it.
Yes, can I?
As a constitutional
may I just answer
as a
you, Rahul?
Indian citizen, I
Rahul,
think
I don't think it can be anybody's case. Sorry, please, if he keeps talking, I can't say anything.
Media.
Let him. Can I? Excuse me, sir, I was asked to answer something. Let me just answer it. See, Rahul, it's a very, very clear situation. A very serious accusation has been made. If that accusation is true, its consequences are also very serious, because if actually what she said is true, it is exceedingly serious and has to be investigated. But equally, if what she has said is not true
And from so far, there are no facts which seem to back it up. I think it would be well within the rights of any investigative authority to ask her on what she's based these statements. And if these statements are not true, and she can make such serious statements at such a sensitive time in this manner, it cannot be pardoned on the basis of freedom of speech at all. And she will have to face the consequences. So the whole thing goes down to what is the factual basis for her saying what she did. And the investigation, if it has started today, as to whether what she has said is either an incitement to violence or promoting communal disharmony or is otherwise defamatory, that investigation will have to see whether what she said had any truth to it, had any facts to back it, and if it did not, she has to face the legal consequences, and freedom of speech is not a defense for her then.
I think it's very clear, Sabha Naqvi, from what Mr. Arima Sundaram said. One second, Mr. Shuran. One second. I'm asking Sabha Naqvi a question. Allow me, please. Sabha Naqvi, this is a test now of proof. If Shehla Rashid can't produce the proof, she needs to go to jail.
No, Rahul, first of all, I hope, I agree with what Mr. Sundaram is saying, that she must show the basis on which, the proof on which she made these statements. However, the manner in which the Public Security Act, all these acts, people are just being picked up and locked up, as Shah Faisal has been done, that I think would be a very unfortunate add-on to putting another Kashmiri under, you know, behind bars, which is what we are ending up doing. We are incarcerating all of them. Let's accept that.
Excuse me.
I hope there is an investigation.
Excuse me. If people are going to break the law, if they don't recognize the spirit and the letter of the Constitution, whether they are Kashmiris, whether they are from any other part of this country, they need to be booked. You can't take the law into your hand and play victim after that.
Did Mahbooba Mufti break the law? No, hang on. I'm making another point here. I'm saying have an investigation.
Excuse me.
Do not pick up people under these laws.
There is no Public Safety Act.
The process of fighting them is the punishment.
You can't make
some. There are laws such as.
You can't speak some rubbish and then expect investigation.
Sabha Naqvi, let me remind you what Mehbooba Mufti and Omar Farooq were saying.
You want people to be
Omar Abdullah was saying, both of them came out and said that Kashmir will burn, that people will come out, they will rip into the Indian state. These were the statements, these were called to action.
So you're justifying?
I'm not justifying anything.
Could he have been
right? The state imposed a curfew, and it has been done in the past.
It is a very
Hang on. The National Conference was very happy when Afzal Guru was being hanged to impose the similar moratorium on communication, on movement and restriction. They were very happy with that when Afzal Guru was hanged. The UPA did it. The Congress party did it. No problems. Then I didn't hear Sabha Naqvi coming out and blathering all over the television saying that, this is a huge crackdown. This has happened on several occasions.
I don't blather all over the television, Rahul. Rahul, if you
this
are
is a fact.
Create some, you accuse me
had
of
this not happened? Had this not happened in the past? Have they been the curfews applied for
point?
The first time? Has curfew
this
been applied for the first
and
time?
You know it and we all know it. What has happened here is big.
Have separatists not been taken in? Put
this
under
is
house
huge
arrest?
And this is
their Twitter accounts suspended? Has this not happened? Has it not happened when arrests have been made of Ram Rahim? Where the internet was shut down? We know this happens.
Rahul.
We know people are detained. Why are you trying to use this as a test case for freedom? I don't understand. And how is it that one side
India's
needs to restrict themselves to the law and the other side can constantly break the law and challenge the state and create all sorts of mayhem?
Rahul, can I come in?
Who the hell is breaking the law?
Shehla Rashid is. Shehla Rashid is. If she is making these statements, she's guilty of breaking the law. The law says very clearly, you make an accusation, you've got to back it up with facts. You've heard Aryama Sundaram. Do you have a problem with him? You think he's a BJP guy? He's a lawyer who's giving you his opinion. Mr. Shuran, tell me.
This is not about the BJP. This is about
Rahul,
the country.
The BJP spokesperson
this is just about
called
what
activists,
I fear for the country,
people from Pakistan.
That we are
he called
over
people
our
from CPI agents of Pakistan and China. Is that not defamation? Whenever someone makes an irresponsible statement, action should be taken.
Well, Mr. Shuran, I don't know which law books you have been reading, but certainly you need to get a new library because those books right over your shoulder there are probably giving you a very, very vexatious and different view of the law. Maybe you're reading them upside down. I don't quite know, sir. I don't know. But there is a serious problem here. There is a group of individuals, hyperactivists, we call them here on Times Now, that have been laboring on with an agenda
like
for
Shehla
days
Rashid,
altogether. They make all sorts
like
of outlandish claims. Pakistan
Kashmiri
picks
Valley,
up those
they
claims. They're
like
echoed
us,
in the international domain. And India gets maligned repeatedly
exactly.
without any proof. Without any proof. And those same
if
people
India
also speak to international
wrong,
journalists and they write huge, long-winded articles suggesting that there is some massive travesty going on in the valley. I leave it at that because there are other stories, viewers, and this is the Times Now exclusive.